in our traditional teachings, the clockwise direction is considered a very sacred direction. It is the direction of life, the continual growth in life. And we are told that everything in our traditional teaching is based on four. So we recognize within our human self as an individual being, we say we are a spirit being first, an emotional being second, and the thinking or mental being third, and then the physical being is fourth. And so it is our responsibility when we experience life in this third world, that's what we call this world, the third world here, everything is based on core, so we can know how to live in the next world, which is the fourth world. But when we arrive here, we arrive at the, as a spirit being, and we enter this physical form right here at the top of the head where the hair grows in a spiral. So everyone's hair grows in that spiral up here. But it is the continual growth direction. These spirals are also found on our fingertips and on the tips of our toes. We are told that this is the marking that we leave behind whenever we touch something or whenever we put our hands on anything. And so we are never to strike our children with our hand or even another the neck. And so the hand and the top area of the skull was considered very sacred, because that's where your spirit enters. When you die, your spirit will enter that same, or exit that same area as it journeys into the next world. But there are many cultures in the world that recognize that particular area of the skull to be very sacred. But many times they're not able to tell you why. But among our people, I just explained and shared that with you, it's where the spirit enters and where the spirit will exit. But other cultures like the Japanese and the Japanese samurai, they tie their topknot right there on that, in that area. The Japanese women put their hair up, and they put their hair up in that area as well. The Chinese, in the various dynasties, the Chinese men would braid their pigtail from that area and then shave the rest of the skull. The Chinese women also put their hair up in that area. And this is the same with our people. When I have when I tie my hair, I gather up all the hair from that where the spirit entered, where the spiral is on the hair, and we wrap that long hair after we fold it up, and we drop the hair. Sometimes it's called a Navajo knot, or sometimes they refer to it as the Navajo bun. But among the Jewish people, the men wear the yarmulke right there on that part of the skull, and the Jewish women, of course, tie their hair up in that area. I didn't mention the Navajo women traditionally would tie their hair up in that area as well. But even the Pope and the Padres, you know, they have that skull cap that they wear on that portion of the skull. So it is that that is considered a very sacred area or spot on the skull. And so this is just one of our teachings that I share with you in full.
Joseph Sikoti and Shet. And what I said was Yate, meaning hello in Navajo. Give it a try, Yate. Yep, yeah, sound like awesome Navajos. Also, what I said was my name and my clans. And our clans are like a family tree to know who we are related to. But does this look familiar to you guys? How, right? The How came from a southern tribe in California. We call the Hollywood tribe. Where Hollywood actually got How from is from the Lakota Sioux tribe. And the right way to pronounce that is Haukula. So it's like saying How and Coca-Cola minus the Coke. Can you guys say Haukula?
Haukula.
Yep, so that's how you say hello in Lakota Sioux. But just so you guys know, no tribes at all say How or do this. That's totally made up. And also, we don't do this. Yeah, we don't do that. Also, what I'm wearing is not called the costume. Or I didn't go to the Native American section in a Walmart and buy this. This is all handmade. Myself, my relatives, or friends have made this for me. This is called the regalia or outfit. It's not called a costume because costumes are something you wear when you're pretending to be something else, say not. And I'm not trying to pretend I'm anything else because I am Native American, so this is called a regalia or outfit. But to start off this evening for you guys, I'm going to share with you guys a song from this drum here. And this drum we refer to as our grandfather, because we're taught that we have to listen to our grandfather and we have to do what he tells us to do. Same thing with the dancer. The dancer has to listen to the drum beat and has to do what the drum beat is telling them to do, which is keep in rhythm. And every drum beat that the drum makes sounds like a heartbeat. So the drum also lets you guys know of what the dancer's heart rate feels like. So it could be a slow pace, medium pace, or fast pace. And I don't know if you guys ever heard of any Native American music, but to you guys, it may sound a lot of like, hey, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah, yeah, right? But there's actually what we call vocables. So I'm gonna give you guys an example of what a vocable is. I'm gonna sing a song and you guys finish it. Old MacDonald had a farm.
Yeah, yeah.
Tis the season to be jolly. Yep, good job. So what are you guys saying with vocables? It doesn't have any words in there, but it's a keep in rhythm with the song and the beat. And those EIOs, we know that's an old MacDonald song. And those falas, we know that's a Christmas song. When we hear these vocables, we know which song goes to which dance. But the song I'm going to share for you guys is not going to be for a dance. This song is it's called a flag song. And so this song is to acknowledge and respect and remember of all those who have fought in battle and those who have fallen in battle. So if you guys have any family members, loved ones, or friends who are currently serving in any armed forces or who have served in armed forces before, it's a good time to think about them throughout the song and be thankful for them. And you guys are also more than welcome to take pictures and videos as well. This year is a flag song. Thank you. And there's a lot of meaning to these. And these songs are only come to our, what we call drum makers and people that know how to make drums and people that know how to come up with these songs. And some of these people, some of these natives, they're gifted with these gifts that they can come up with these songs. So also another question, some questions we get asked often as well as Native Americans is, can you guys, or do you guys still eat the buffalo? Yeah, the wings. Or can you guys do the rain dance? If we could do the rain dance and it did rain, we would be very rich. But a lot of these dances are not to control the weather. These dances are more to be thankful for something or someone, a storytelling dance, a healing dance, or a celebration dance. And each of these dances that we'll be sharing for you guys this evening are competed in what we call a powwow. And a powwow is a gathering of Native Americans that come together to socialize and compete in dance. And each of these dances are from different tribes as well. We're all Navajo, but these are not Navajo dances. Navajo dances are more ceremonial and not for the general public. There's actually 573 tribes federally recognized within the U.S., and there's still over 100 tribes that are not federally recognized. So since that there's 573 tribes, tonight we're going to show you guys each dance from each tribe. So buckle down, get comfortable. No, I'm just kidding. We got a few dances for you guys. So this first dance that I'm going to share is going to be done by these beautiful girls. This dance is called the Women's Jingle Dress Dance. This dance came from the Ojibwe tribe. This dance is also known as a healing dance. And notice as these girls walk up, the dress sounds like rain. Just like the rain, when it comes down, it heals Mother and replenishes. And there's 365 cones wrapped around their dress, representing each day of the year. And each jingle is made out of a tobacco candlet, because tobacco is a very sacred herb in a Native tradition. We use it in our prayers and ceremonies. So here we have the Shemi, and this here is Aaron, and this here is a woman's jingle dress. Let's give these girls a hand.
Hey, hey, yeah, yeah.
Back in 1492, it was actually 250,000 plus different Native American tribes within North America and Canada. And a lot of these tribes died off when the overseas came, from people over from overseas came over and brought these diseases. And a lot of these tribes died from a simple cold or a simple flu. And our ancestors, their bodies weren't immune to that yet. And so a simple cold would kill them. And just these simple sicknesses would wipe off a whole tribe. And the Navajo tribe is actually the largest Native American tribe within the US. And on the internet, it actually says Cherokee is the largest Native American tribe. That's because Cherokee goes down to 1/16. If you're 1/16 Cherokee, you have what's called a CIB. It stands for Certification of Indian Blood. And you have the benefits as a Native American to that tribe. For Navajos, it's only a quarter. And so some of the benefits that we have is we have free healthcare. We also have free schooling on the reservation. So you can go to college for free. If you want to go to school off the reservation to college, we have different Native American grants, Navajo grants as well. But now this next dance that we have is going to be done by Shaylee and her little sister Zendaya. And this dance is called the Women's Fancy Shawl Dance. This dance came from the Ponca tribe. This dance was inspired by the butterfly. And the tribe, they saw the butterfly, the way it moved, the way it looked. Just like the butterfly, it's very beautiful and colorful and different designs, just like the regalia that these girls are wearing. This dance is also one of the most athletic dances in the women's category. So this jump will start off with a slow beat. We'll start progressing to more of a faster and louder beat. This first beat that you'll be dancing to is called a double beat. It's also called a crow hop. And the story behind a crow hop is, before there was any human beings on this planet, it was just the animals, the birds, and a lot of four-legged beings. And the world was coming to an end. There was no more light on the earth. The light was very dim. The sun was very dim. And so all the animals got together and they said, who would be the one to go up to the holy people and bring back the light? And so the crow, who was the one that actually volunteered. Back then, the crow had beautiful, colorful wings, beautiful, colorful feathers, had a beautiful singing voice. It was also one of the smartest birds as well. And so the crow flew up and met the holy people and asked how they can bring the sun back. And they said, you go up to the sun, grab a piece of the sun, and you fly back down to earth to bring it down. And so as the crow, the only way to grab the sun was with his beak. And so the crow grabbed a piece of the sun with the beak and it was flying down. As it was flying down, the sun burnt all its beautiful feathers and turned it black. Turned its beautiful singing voice into what you hear as a caw. But the crow did bring the light back down. And so the double beat, the crow hop, is to remember and honor the crow. And so this, you'll notice the double beat has like a crow hop beat. It'll sound like a crow would be hopping. But like I said, as the drum gets faster and louder, you guys get louder as well. They feed off of your energy. So the louder you guys are, the better these girls will dance for you guys. This here is Zendaya, and this here is Shaylee. This is the Women's Fancy Shawl. Let's give these girls a hand.
Yeah.
the tribe would do is he would construct a flute and play the flute for a lady that he would want to marry. And if she liked it, she would acknowledge him. If she didn't, she would grab his flute and break it. And he would reconstruct a new flute into a better tune that she would like. But also, while I'm playing this flute, you guys are more than welcome to visualize what you guys are thankful in this life. But also, this the flute is was also made because it's a very good stress reliever. As I'm playing this song as well, think of all your problems throughout your life. Think of whatever is stressing you out. Think of a way to fix that. Think of a solution. We get so caught up in our lives and our problems that we forget to, you know, take a deep breath and let all that stress out, let all that negativity out. And when we're taught to play the flute, we're taught to think of those things as well and take that deep breath and blow it into the flute and turn something beautiful into it. Choreography in high school, and then a semester of ballet in college, and hoop dance is actually the latest dance I picked up. The reason why I would like to share this with you guys is because my goal is to break the stereotype of what you guys see Native Americans. So a lot of people think that we still live in teepees, we still live out in the middle of nowhere, completely isolated from the world, but that's not true. I actually had an experience a few months ago. I was in my regalia getting ready to do a performance, and I was on my phone, probably checking my Facebook, and a couple walked past by me. I heard the wife whisper to her husband, she said, "I didn't know Indians use cell phones." And so my message is that we still move with the modern world. At the same time, we still believe and practice our traditional ways as well. So I'm going to turn the time over to Haas. He's going to explain a little bit more about myself and the hoop dance. And I'm going to do a quick change into my hoop outfit. But help me welcome Haas back on stage. Thank you. The super could represent maybe your job. Sometimes our jobs can be stressful and we fall down as well. The super could represent maybe your school. Sometimes school can be tough and we fall down. The super could represent your Wi-Fi. Gives you problems, right? The super could represent your ex. Your other crazy ex. But all these soups here start piling up and begins to look like a pile of mess, like you see here, just as in life. What we gotta do in life is when we struggle and fall down, we gotta be like the hoop dance. As you guys saw me throughout the stance, I picked up one hoop at a time, working with it and creating something beautiful with it. Just as in life, we gotta pick up one problem at a time and work with it and create something beautiful with it as well. So here, we can't let our problems pile up on us and weigh us down. We gotta pick up our problems in life and fix them. Pick up these soups and fix them. And rebuild our world again.